Hello and welcome back to a new video on the Crypto2 YouTube channel. In this video, I want to show you how you can make and break Playfair ciphers in Crypto2. I created some slides as introduction for the topic. First, I want to show you the history of the Playfair cipher. Then, I want to show you what is a Playfair cipher. And finally, we will do it in Crypto2. The Playfair cipher was invented in 1854 by Charles Wheatstone, who was a British physician. You can see Charles Wheatstone here on the right side. Lord Lyon Playfair, who was a friend of Charles Wheatstone, promoted the usage of the cipher to the British military. And because of that, the cipher was named after him. You can see Lord Lyon Playfair here. The Playfair cipher is a bigraphic monoalphabetic substitution cipher. What this means, we will see on later slides. The Playfair cipher was first used in the Crimean War in 1854, and it was last used during World War I. The Playfair cipher was broken in mid of 1915 by the Germans. But adapted versions of the Playfair cipher were used in World War II by Germans and British. What is the Playfair cipher? As I already said, the Playfair cipher is a bigraphic monoalphabetic substitution cipher. What does this mean? Bigraphic means that two symbols, in the case of the Playfair cipher, two letters, are encrypted at the same time. As you see here on the right, AB is encrypted to JH, for example, AC to UI, and so on and so on, and ZY is encrypted to PX. Then the Playfair cipher is monoalphabetic. What does this mean? Monoalphabetic means that only one ciphertext alphabet is used. We already had a video on simple monoalphabetic substitution ciphers, so if you're interested in details on these, I would suggest you to have a look at this video. In contrast to monoalphabetic, we could have polyalphabetic, where after encrypting, for instance, a single letter, another ciphertext alphabet would be used. An example for such a cipher is a Visionaire cipher. We already have a video about the Visionaire cipher, so if you're interested in details on the Visionaire cipher, you should have a look at this video. And finally, we have substitution, which just means that symbols or letters are replaced by other symbols or letters. So, how does the Playfair cipher actually work? The first step is that we have to create a table which is based on a keyword. For example, secret key. The table is 5x5. That means we can only encrypt 25 letters. Thus, the letter J has to be replaced by I. We fill in the secret key by just adding its letters to the table, but when we have to add a letter that we already added, we have to omit this. For instance, the second E in secret, or the third E in key. After we wrote the keyword or text into our table, we have to add the remaining letters of the alphabet until the complete table is filled. Then we have some rules for preparing the plain text before encryption, and we have rules for encryption. The first step we have to do is to remove double letters, for instance AA, BB, CC, and so on. We do this by adding an X between the double letter. So instead of writing AA, we write AXA. Instead of writing BB, we write BXB, and so on. Then we have to make the plaintext length even by adding an X at the end. We have to do this because Playfair works on bigrams, thus the plaintext has to be of even length. So how do we actually encrypt letters using this table or the Playfair cipher? We have to find and replace our bigrams, bigram by bigram. We have three different rules that describe what we have to do. The first rule is, if letters appear in the same column, let's assume our bigram is EG. Then we take the letters right of these two letters, CH, and encrypt the E with an C and the G with an H. Then we could have the case where letters are in the same row. Then we have to take the letters in the next row. For example, if we want to encrypt YB, we have to encrypt the Y with an G and the B with an I. In both cases, if we have columns or rows, we have to wrap around. For instance, if we want to encrypt VX, then in this case we have to wrap around to E and R. Then we have our third rule, that is when letters are on a rectangle, like this here. We want to encrypt the E and Q, and we go to the other corners of the rectangle. In this case, the E goes to T and the Q goes to N. So, what is the key space size of a Playfair cipher? We have 25 factorial different possible tables, because we have to add 25 letters to this table, and in the first case, or for the first letter, we have 25 positions where we could add the letter. For the second letter, then we have only 24, for the third, only 23, and so on. And we have, of course, to multiply the possibilities. Thus, we have 25 factorial different possible tables. And 25 factorial is about 2 to the power of 84. So the Playfair cipher has a really huge key space. Now let's do it in Crypto 2. We have two different tasks. Task A is to encrypt and decrypt using the Playfair cipher. And the task B, of course, is to break a Playfair cipher or a ciphertext which was encrypted using the Playfair cipher. I'm now here in Crypto 2. I want to show you how you can create your own Playfair cipher. To do so, you first click on the icon for the Workspace Manager. In the Workspace Manager, we make some more space. Then we search for Playfair. And we have the Playfair cipher here, and drag and drop the component using the mouse on the workspace. The Playfair cipher has some inputs. A text input for plain text or ciphertext, and it has a text input for a key phrase. And then it has some different outputs. The preformatted input string, that is what I already showed you in the introduction. You cannot, for instance, encrypt double letters, or the plain text has to have even length. And when you put in a plain text here, the auto-formatted plain text is here outputted. Then we have a text output for plain text or ciphertext. And finally, we can also output the key. So let's create a text input for the plain text. And we need a text input for the key. We arrange this in the corner. And then we connect the plain text to the input, and we connect the key to the input. And then we need a text output for the ciphertext. Just drag and drop it here, then Crypto2 automatically creates it for me. And I rename this to ciphertext. Then our plain text is. And our key is secret key. And we want to see the key, so we make an additional output. And we will name it key. And we will also connect it here. So this is not ciphertext, this is a pre-formatted plain text. Copy this again. Remove this here a little. And this here is our ciphertext. Let's have a look at the settings. So the action is encrypt, the key phrase the component will get from the outside, and the rest is okay. The metric size is 5.5, and let's try it. So we have our pre-formatted plain text, and as you see, the LL of hello gets an X in the middle, and at the end, the X is added. Our key is secret Y, A, B, and so on. This should be the same key as I showed you in the introduction. So now let's test if we can also decrypt using Playfair. To do so, I copy all these components here with Ctrl C and Ctrl V to the right side. Then I connect the ciphertext with the input here. Some more space that the line can actually go here. And then, of course, we have to connect the key. And we have to change the second Playfair component to decrypt. We don't need the pre-formatted plaintext, and our ciphertext is decrypted plaintext. I will arrange this a little. A key we also don't need. This is set to decrypt. Okay, let's test it. And as you can see here, we have here our ciphertext and we have the decrypted plaintext. And the decrypted plaintext, of course, is the same as the pre-formatted plaintext that our initial Playfair component created. So now let's break a Playfair cipher. I'm now back in the start center of Crypto 2 and I want to show you how you can break a Playfair cipher. For breaking a Playfair cipher, we already created a template. So you can just search for Playfair and you open the Playfair analysis template. In the template, you see different components. First, you can see here is a ciphertext component or a text input component where you can add the ciphertext. Then you see the Playfair analyzer. The Playfair analyzer is based on methods that George Lasry developed. I will link the paper about this below this video. Here you see a text output component which will show you the decrypted plaintext, and then we have another text output component which will show you the found key. Let's add a ciphertext. I created a 716 letter long ciphertext encrypted using the Playfair cipher, but of course you could use even smaller ciphertexts. But the shorter the ciphertext is, the longer the analysis takes. And since this is a video and I don't want to bore you with looking at a Playfair analysis component just running, I add a long ciphertext. So let's have a look at the Playfair analyzer component settings. In the component, you can change, for instance, the threads, then you can change cycles. This is important for the hill climbing algorithm that's running in the background of the Playfair analyzer, but 1000 is a good number. Then you can change the language that should be used. Right now we can only use English, but we will add additional languages. Then you have some other settings like discard the same plaintext for the analysis, and you can change the analysis view to advanced best list view. One hint, when you use the component on your own the first time, the component will download about 700 megabytes of language statistics for the English language. This will take some time. I already did this on this computer, so we can start it immediately. So let's give it a try. And as you can see here, after about 45 to 49 seconds, the analyzer found the correct plaintext. The Playfair cipher or Playfair square or Wheatstone Playfair and so on. Sometimes the analysis can take some more time, sometimes the analysis is faster. This is since the algorithm is a heuristic and it's based on randomness, so you just have to wait. And this was everything that I wanted to show you with the Playfair cipher in Crypto 2. I hope that you liked the video, so please give a thumbs up. If you're interested in more videos, you could also subscribe to our channel, and I hope that I can see you in the next time.